covering. Right. Tell us a little bit about this.
Well, I mean, if it doesn't get down really, really cold, it just touches there and moves right back up, it's not going to do really much damage. You know, some tropicals maybe, it may burn some of the fruits off, the flowers off of citrus, but it shouldn't, you know, the citrus will reflower, so you'll be all right. Okay, listen, we got the southern rabbit eye, not southern high bush, but rabbit eye blueberries, and they're a wonderful plant, high in antioxidants, great for you, and fairly easy to grow. You know, some of the things you need to do about, they're really sensitive about the type of soil there. They don't like it soggy, they want organic material in the soil, which we don't normally find in Florida, you know, because it's just one big sandbar, but, you know, here's what I do. I mix one third bark, one third sand, and one third compost, and I burn them up, you know, in a good area. Make sure it does not soak in water. Or if you got a wet area, or if you want to try a planting box, that's going to assure that you get good soil conditions. The pH on this, on blueberries, is around 4 to 4.5. This is very, you know, low, which you're not normally going to find. So you're going to have to make sure you put pine bark. Pine bark is going to acidify the soil, or sphagnum moss is another thing, peat moss. Make sure that you control the weeds. They don't like a lot of weeds there. They have sensitive root systems. They grow along the surface. You know, they don't get deep. So you want to put at least 4 to 5 inches of pine straw. Why I like pine straw is because it doesn't wash away, and it kind of forms this nice mat, and it dries out. So it doesn't absorb too much of the water either when it runs through there, and that's going to keep the soil acidic.
And you know, my grandfather always used to have pine straw around the bottom of the base of his plants through the wintertime, right, but always took it out for the springtime.
Right.
Is it getting too late in the season for pine straw?
Well, no, it's a good thing for blueberries. Yeah, you got to have it on there. Then some of the things you want to also remember is that when you're fertilizing, you want to use, you know, organic fertilizer. You can use 14-14-14 Osmocote. You can get all these things at Ice Harbor. They actually have a great selection of blueberries, but you want to use this, and you don't want to put too much on them because their roots are right next to the soil. I would say put a little less than put a lot on them. Make sure that you get that around every other month, starting in April, then skip a month in June, and get that fertilizer on them. Note, some of the things that happens to them when they get older is they get less productive. And you can look at this blueberry here. See how this one has that woody branching there?
Yes.
And that's going to be unproductive. And then you look carefully here, and you see these new green branches, and you can see the flowers,
right.
You can see the blueberries. This becomes a productive part. So pruning these woody branches out about one third a year makes a big difference in the productivity. Cutting the top off of them is another thing you can do. When you plant them, you want to make sure that you don't put the fertilizer on them right away. So let them get established. Some of these bugs they get, they don't get too many.
I was going to ask, actually.
You know, some copper on them for fungicide would be the best thing. Sometimes they get some fungus on the blueberries and on the flowers. You know, that's best prevented by spraying early in the spring. And you're going to have a great crop with these. They're very easy to grow. You'll get your first crop around between May and June.
All right. Well, thank you for joining us this morning, Larry. For more information on gardening, or if you would like Larry to do